Hello, junior campers. I know that this is not the camp that we thought we would have this year, but I believe that God has given us this time to go deeper in our relationship with Him and that He still has a message to get across. And to all of you who are not our awesome 8, 9, and 10-year-olds, you are in luck because this week, you too are a junior camper. So welcome to the virtual Camp Hickory Hills experience. Now, little did our staff know that while we were praying for our campers, we were also praying for you. And I believe that God has a message for each and every one of you who will tune in. Each day this week, we will go deeper in our relationship with God. We will dive in headfirst as we learn to go deeper through the Word of God, deeper by prayer, by listening for God's voice, and by telling others about His amazing and extravagant love. So be sure to tune in, and if you haven't already, go ahead and be sure to like the Camp Hickory Hills page so you will be notified when a new post is up. So grab your Bibles, a pen and paper, and maybe even a snack, and let's spend some time in God's presence this week. So without further ado, I present to you Junior Camp 2020 Deeper.
Okay, Scott, it's time for the theme song.
Yeah, Shay. What do I do?
Let's see. I know. You can play this.
I don't want to play that. I'll look silly.
Oh, come on. It'll be fun.
Nope. Not gonna do it.
It's for the kids.
Oh, okay. But they better not laugh.
All right. Better get on out there. Got a show for you.
Junior Camp Devotions. Junior Camp Devotions. Junior Camp Devotions. Junior Camp Devotions.
Quarantine, distancing, COVID-19.
Junior Camp.
Feel God's power.
It's time for
You know, growing up, I had a fear of not only diving, but of swimming. I remember my uncle throwing me in the pool and yelling at me to swim. I was 4. Even to this day, whenever I get ready to jump into the water, I have to pump myself up. You know, because there's many different reasons that I get nervous. After all, I'm not the best swimmer. I'm terrified of fish. And what if I belly flop and everybody laughs at me? For the longest time, I was afraid to step in the water. You know, we all get scared every once in a while, even people in the Bible. I tell you what, you want to hear a story? Why don't you come with me to church and I'll tell you all about a man who had the boldness to step out into the water. All right, let's turn our Bibles to Matthew 14 and we're going to be reading verses 22 through 33. You ready? Immediately, Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go out ahead of him to the other side, while he dismissed the crowd. After he had dismissed them, he went up on the mountainside by himself to pray. Later that night, he was there alone, and the boat was already a considerable distance from the land, buffeted by the waves because the wind was against it. Shortly before dawn, Jesus went out to them, walking on the lake. When the disciples saw him walking on the lake, they were terrified. "It's a ghost," they said, and cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, "Take courage. It is I. Do not be afraid." "Lord, if it is you," Peter replied, "tell me to come to you on the water." "Come," he said. Then Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, and came toward Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid and began sinking, crying out, "Lord, save me." Immediately Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. "You of little faith," he said, "why did you doubt?" And when they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Then those who were in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." Many times when we hear the story of Jesus walking on the water, we are told of Peter, who finds himself sinking into stormy seas when he begins to doubt Jesus. But if we only focus on the moment that Peter sinks, we will have missed the most wonderful and promising part of the story. Peter walked on the water just like Jesus. Now, yes, I get it. He sinks after he begins to doubt and his faith wavers, but for a brief moment, Peter walked on water. He showed great faith in getting out of the boat and going to Jesus in the first place. Remember during the time, a lot of the other disciples were freaking out because they thought that they were still seeing a ghost. What sets Peter apart in this story is that Peter had boldness. You see, although it was weak, Peter had faith. Faith? Well, that's a funny word. Isn't that also like a girl's name? Well, actually, Hebrews 11:1 tells us exactly what faith is. The scripture reads, "Now faith is confidence in what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see." This week is all about going deeper in a relationship with God. But he's not just going to start a relationship with us himself. Just like he called out to Peter, God calls out to each one of us. We just have to be willing to be bold and take that first step out of the boat and onto the water. A lot of times we're scared because we don't know what's to come. We may be scared because we're afraid that we will sink in the water. Maybe we're afraid of what our friends will think of us. Perhaps we're scared because God wants us to do something that we're uncomfortable with. Maybe we think that God doesn't love us. Or maybe a thought pops in your head that maybe God isn't real. These are the complete opposite of faith. These are called doubts. But you can't let these thoughts, these doubts, consume you. You have to have faith because that is what relationships are built on. So what's holding you back?
I'm sort of having the realization that you have to be able to go. The hesitation is the thing that really messes up the chance at having your dreams. Get out of the middle. The moment of pushing off is pure freaking terror. There's nothing to hold on to. We're all trying to hold on to something. You're trying to hold on to an idea, or you're trying to hold on to a person, and we gotta just get comfortable falling. Life is dangerous. The only way to really enjoy it is jump and be free.
Have you ever been standing on the diving board at the city pool? Or maybe even about to jump out of the swing when it gets to the highest point that it can? Perhaps you've stood at the top of the hill at the campground, getting pumped and ready to zoom down the slip and slide. That rush, that thrill that you get, it's called adrenaline. That's what it's like being in a relationship with God. You never know what He's going to do in your life. You get closer to Him and you study His Word, and you even can be filled with His Holy Spirit. Jesus loves you very much. His love is exhilarating. Say that word with me. Exhilarating. His love is extravagant. Let's say that. Extravagant. And His love is enough. Say that with me. Enough. God's love sets us free. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whosoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have eternal life." You see, when we are born into this world, we're born into sin. So you know what God did? He sent down His Son, Jesus Christ, to live and die on a cross for me, for you, for your mother, your father, your brother, your sister, your aunt, your best friend, your uncle, your cousin, your teachers, and everyone else. Why? Because He loves us, and He wanted to make sure that we have a way to an everlasting life in heaven forever. So you don't have to be afraid to step in a relationship with God. Have faith that He died for you and that He's preparing a place for you in heaven. But how do we take that first step, or how do we take that leap of faith? John 14:6 says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." And those are red letters. You know what that means, right? Red letters are the words spoken by Jesus Himself. So to answer the question, starting your relationship with God is as easy as A, B, C. The A stands for admit. Romans 3:23 says, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." That's right, everyone, including me and you. Now, you've probably got some things coming to mind of how you have broken God's laws in the past, and sin is a problem because it separates us from God, who is without sin. Romans 6:23 says, "For the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord." Just as you earn a wage for doing your chores, we earn wages for our actions. The Bible tells us that sin earns us death. Well, eternal death and separation from God for all of eternity. But it also gives us hope for eternal life through Jesus Christ. The B stands for believe. Now, we've already talked a little bit about how God gave His only Son for us, but the Bible also says that Jesus Christ, God's Son, was sent here to die in our place. And you can read about that in Romans 5:8. Sin can't go unpunished, but God doesn't want anyone to die. And that's why He sent His Son, Jesus. Jesus Christ lived His entire life without any sin. He had to be perfect in order to die for the sins of others. And in doing so, He paid the penalty for your sin. When you truly admit that your sin has separated you from God, and when you truly believe that Jesus Christ died to make it right, there's only one way you can respond. And that's why the C stands for confess. Romans 10:9 says, "If you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, and you believe with your heart that God raised Him from the dead, you will be saved." Jesus gave His life in exchange for yours. What could you possibly offer in return but to live your life for Him? When you submit your life to Jesus Christ as your Lord, you become a part of God's family. And the way you live your life and the choices that you make will show it. If you want to start or renew your relationship with God today, I'm going to ask that you pray with me. And I want you to do it with faith and with all of your heart, as you repeat these words after me. So let's pray. Dear God, I know that I'm a sinner and I need a Savior. I want to turn away from my sinful life to the life You have planned for me. Please forgive me for my sins. Cleanse me of my past and make me new. I know your Son, Jesus Christ, died for me. And I believe in my heart that you raised him from the dead. I accept, confess, and proclaim Jesus Christ as my personal Lord and Savior to live in my heart from this day forward. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me from my sins. And please send your Holy Spirit to guide me for the rest of my life. In Jesus' name, amen. If you admitted that you're a sinner, if you believe with all your heart that Jesus died for you, and if you confessed that Jesus is your one true Lord and Savior, and that you will live your life for Him, congratulations. You have just been saved by the grace of God and have officially started your relationship with Him.
Jump and be free.
Wow, what a great first day of junior camp. So let's review and talk about what we've learned today.
And so what we have learned applies to our lives today. God has a lot to say in His book.
Well, that was random. Anyways, you see,
we know that God's word is for everyone. And now that our song is done, we'll take a look.
So, is that all the music, or are we... Okay, I guess we're good. Today, we talked about what it means to be in a relationship with God, and we learned that we have to push aside our doubts and step into the water with faith. Some of you even went an extra step to relearn your ABCs and began your relationship with God by admitting you're a sinner, believing that Christ died for you, and confessing that He is your Lord and Savior. I'd like to introduce you to my computer friend here. His name is QWERTY. One of my favorite things about QWERTY is that he always has a good Bible verse to share. So let's see what he has for us today. You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart. Jeremiah 29:13. What do you say we read this together?
You will seek me and find me when you seek me with all your heart. Jeremiah 29:13.
This week is all about going deeper in our relationship with God and His Son, Jesus Christ. We will look at how we can better study our Bibles, pray to God, listen for God's voice, and tell others about His love. So be sure to tune in each day this week. But before you go, I'd like to pray with you. Would you bow your heads with me? Dear God, I just want to praise you and thank you for allowing us to come together. Even though we're separate, we were able to join together for this virtual devotion. I praise you and I thank you for the relationship that we have built together because, Lord, we know that without you, we will not be able to get through our Christian walks. Dear Lord, I pray that these campers will understand that if they truly admit that they are a sinner, and if they truly believe that you came and that you died for their sins, dear God, and that if they confess with their tongues that you are the one true Savior, dear God, that they can have an awesome and an amazing relationship with you, God. Dear Lord, we're ready for whatever it is that you have for us to receive this week, and we praise you and we thank you. In your holy name, amen. Each day we will end our devotion with a challenge, kind of like a dare. Now today was all about not being afraid of stepping in the water, but I'm not going to dare you to jump in a pool or even a lake. No, I challenge you to take a spiritual leap of faith. Dive right into a relationship with God by admitting that you are a sinner, believing that Jesus died for your sins and that you might be saved, and confess that you are a believer of Jesus Christ. But that's not all, because this is a double dare. I double dog dare you to tune in each day this week as we go deeper in our relationship with Christ. Are you willing to step in the water? Or better yet, are you willing to dive in?